and welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'm going to be showing you some beautiful books for the season of summer. So as you all know, I absolutely love to create seasonal rituals and celebrations with my children. It's something I do for myself personally as well, but I also do it for my two little boys. So it's really important for me each summer to kind of think of what books I could read to them or what celebrations I could share with them that's going to really enrich the weeks to come and just create lots of presents and slow living around the season of summer. And this is why I do beautiful summer books for my kids. I do the same during the whole year with autumn, winter, spring, and it just makes our lives so much more beautiful and lovely, and it's something I really look forward to each year and each change of the season. Themes around sun, midsummer, fairies, the sea, and I think I've got some really good picks this year to share with you. So if you want to go back and watch my previous summer books videos, please do. I'll link them below. I've tried to keep it relatively new this year for you, so there should be quite a few books I haven't shared in those previous videos. So if you want to find even more books that we're going to be reading over the coming weeks, check out the links below. And before I get started, I also want to share with you that I have a Patreon account. So I have a Patreon account for anyone that loves seasonal slow living. You can find it at patreon.com/BeckyOcole. It's a great way of supporting this channel and my podcast. Links below, and thank you so much. And without further ado, let's get started with the books. I had a little theme going on, and it was fairies, and especially with the idea of midsummer at the end of June, and the idea of like the sort of garden coming alive with all the flowers, and the idea of these sort of fairies running around and the midsummer celebrations. That really captured my imagination. And so I got some books that kind of went around that theme of fairies and using your imagination as a child and that kind of escapist quality. So first up is this stunning book by one of my favourite illustrators, Phoebe Wahl. It's called Backyard Fairies. And it's quite a simple little book, but it's really so beautifully illustrated that I just couldn't recommend it enough. It's about a little girl who is on the hunt for fairies. And there's some beautiful illustrations, like I say, very, very engaging for children. Like, look at that, it's so gorgeous. Like I said, a nice simple story, not too many words, but so many gorgeous illustrations to get lost in. So a stunning book. A new book this year, and a treat for my boys and myself, let's face it, is A Natural History of Fairies by Emily Hawkins and Jessica Rue. So this is kind of like a make-believe book as if fairies were real. So it has like a guide to all the different things that they like to wear and eat. That's about their wings. And there's so much information in this. It's so, so fun. Really sweet guide. Loads of gorgeous, intricate illustrations in this one. I can imagine lots of little fairy lovers being absolutely enthralled by this book. Tons of pages. A great book to gift to a fairy crazy child, and a lovely one that we've added into our library. So carrying on with the theme of fairies, I brought back out this book. We've had this for a year, I think. It's The Midsummer Tomte and the Little Rabbits by Ulf Stark and Eva Erickson. And I know I've said Tomte wrong because a few of you have corrected me in the past, but I always forget it. So do leave me a comment below letting me know how to pronounce Tomte. And this is all about Midsummer Party and this grumpy little Tomte. It's a great book, great read aloud to do with children. There's lots of words in this one, but also some really lovely illustrations. A detailed illustration. So pictures to look at through this book, and a lovely one to read all summer. I'm not very strict with myself about the whole midsummer thing. To me, midsummer kind of just encapsulates that atmosphere of the peak of summer. So we sort of celebrate it all through July as well as the beginning of, or the end of June. So this book is a lovely one that you can read through the whole summer together as a family. Another new purchase, and it's This Is Sadie by Sarah O'Leary and Julie Morstad. This is not strictly a summer book, but I thought it really sort of captured that whole idea of childlike imagination so wonderfully. So it's about a little girl called Sadie and all the different things that she imagines herself to be. The illustrations are very beautiful in this one, and the story is very captivating for children. My boys love this. She can do all sorts of things like fly, And then of course she loves her books as well, and it's just so gorgeous. I think this would be a great book for all year round, but I also thought it was very spring and summery, so a nice one for our shelves this season. Ballerina and A Midsummer Night's Dream by James Matthew. And this one is a very sweet story about a little ballerina, and she falls into a magical world of The Midsummer's Night Dream by Shakespeare. It's a great way of teaching a bit of Shakespeare to children, but without it being too intense. And I just love all the colours in this. It's so, so beautiful. Very, very gorgeous. And another retelling of A Midsummer's Night Dream is this beautiful one illustrated by Jane Ray. And this one is actually authorised by the Shakespeare's Globe, which is really cool. And the illustrations in this, again, are just so transportative. They are incredible. I love Jane Ray's work so much. She's one of my favourite illustrators, actually. And I think these are just so beautiful. A little book about Midsummer is this gorgeous chapter read aloud book by Reg Down. And it's The Midsummer Tales of Tiptoes Lightly and The Summer Queen. So this one is broken down into chapters. There's a few little small illustrations on each page, which are perfect for a first reader, or if you want to read aloud to your children. This is really good. We've read a couple of chapters and it's so sweet and magical. We also have Sam Usher's Son. So Sam Usher has written quite a few of these books based on weathers. So we've got Storm, Rain, Snow, and Sun was one of the ones I thought would be perfect for summer, obviously, and one that we didn't have. So I purchased this one this year. I really like his stories. It always revolves around a grandfather and a little boy going on adventures together, and this one, it follows the same theme of those other books. Lots of fun text to read aloud, really gorgeous, engaging pictures. There's even some pirates in this one, and lots and lots to see for kids that like lots of busy little illustrations. So a gorgeous one by Sam Usher, and I love all his books. So one of our favourite finds this year has been Summer Days and Nights by Wong Herbert Yee. And this book follows the day of this little girl as she goes through her summer's day and night. And what I really love about this, apart from the really sweet illustrations, is the wording of it. So it's kind of got like a rhyme, but the way it reads is just so poetic and just really engaging for a child. Like, I can't really describe it, but it just works really well. And the way it goes all the way to nighttime as well is just so sweet. Highly recommend it. And actually on the back there is a couple of other books by the same author, which I'm going to check out. There's Tracks in the Snow and Who Likes Rain. I do highly recommend this for toddlers and young children. It's really, really sweet. Now, fireflies are a great theme for summer as well, and I do have a couple of firefly books that I love. This is one of them, and this is by Diana Ochiltree and Betsy Snyder. And I think I might have shared this in a previous video, or possibly a Morning Basket video, but it's a very simple little story and follows a little girl who's on the hunt for fireflies. Lots of really sort of beautiful, bright little illustrations. Some facts about fireflies at the end. Yeah, I just think it's got like something really charming about it. Really, really sweet, very simple, but a cute book that introduces the whole idea of fireflies to children. So on the theme of insects is this beautiful book, The Woolly Bear Caterpillar by Julia Donaldson, illustrated by Yuval Sommer, who is a fantastic illustrator. Now, as you can see, this is from the library, but I definitely will be getting my own copy of this because look how beautiful it is. And my children are fascinated by all bugs and insects. And this one is actually quite educational. It gives you lots of interesting facts about caterpillars and just page upon page of stunning, stunning illustrations. So real 10 out of 10 for this book, one that you could read through spring and summer. And yeah, it's just beautiful. Back onto the theme of fairies. Now, I know I've got two little boys, I don't have any girls, but I don't care. I still read them books about fairies. And this one is The Fairy Garden by Georgia Buckthorne, illustrated by Isabella Mazzanti. And I just thought this was really pretty. It's all about a little girl who's desperate to see fairies in her garden. And she tries to keep her garden as tidy as possible, and the fairies never come. And eventually the fairies appear and tell her to be basically more of an environmental gardener. And so she learns to rewild her garden, and then all her fairies come back into the garden. And at the end, it teaches you how to have a fairy-friendly garden and how to make some fairy houses. So this could be a great one if you've got a child who's not really interested in gardening or perhaps sort of the environmental aspect of gardening. This could be a great introduction into that, because if they love fairies, you could kind of go from the angle of making a fairy-friendly garden as opposed to a bug-friendly garden or a wildlife-friendly garden. So it could be a great one for any child that's fairy crazy and you want to get them outdoors a bit more. I think this is fantastic. This author is new to me, and it's Benjamin Flau, and this is The Golden Glow. And he's written a couple of books actually that look really, really good. And this I kind of felt was the summer version, although I think it would work quite well for autumn too. And the illustrations in this are really cool. I haven't really seen anything like this before. And it's all about this fox who wants to go find a very particular flower up in the mountains. And as you can see, there are some actual factual things through this book as well, which is fantastic. And really, really good illustrations in this. And he goes walking up the hill and, you know, spoiler alert, he finds the flower. And it's got this lovely sort of shiny foil effect. And he does a little drawing, so again, like another little factual page. And he ends up back home in his little burrow. And it's just a beautiful little cozy tale. Really interesting. Like I said, it's got lots of facts. Very beautifully done. And the illustrations are a little bit different, but really charming. So a lovely book. And I'm looking forward to trying out more of his stories as well. So back onto the theme of escapism and children using their imagination. I saw this book. This is new out this year. And I thought, oh, I have to give this one a go. And it's Olivia Hope's Be Wild, Little One, illustrated by Daniel Agnias. And it's got a little shout out by Shirley Hughes at the top, who I think we all love. So that's a good start. And it's a very simple story, but basically it's just showing all the different ways you can imagine amazing magical things with really fantastic, like absorbing illustrations. And yeah, it really just encourages children to be wild and explore their imagination and think of all the different things they can do with it. And I just love this one. It's just such a wonderful one that kind of encapsulates that spirit of summer and play and, you know, running around and being a bit crazy and wild. So I love this. I think it's really charming. Now, you all know that I love Elle Scabesco, so of course I had to include one of her stories. And this is The Sun Egg. This is from the little mini collection that we have. Although I have to say I do prefer the larger copies. So this is a really sweet little story about an orange that lands in a forest, and everyone's trying to wind up what it is. They all think it's the sun. So it's really, really charming, as you can imagine from Elle Scabesco. Really beautiful, a bit like a sort of Beatrix Potter story, but all foresty and just very sweet. Such a fan of this series by Nosy Crow and National Trust. It's Look What I Found at the Seaside, and there is Look What I Found at the Forest, and I think there's another one as well. And it's by Moira Butterfield and Jesus Verona. And it's a little story about going to the seaside, but it also is very interactive. So it kind of encourages you to look at things like all the shells, and then there's some really great little facts at the side. Some kids searching the rock pools. And then some information about what you can find, some crabs. So it sort of goes through all the different aspects that you could see on the beach, and then gives you some sort of scientific detail as well. And there's also a sort of search and find element to it at the same time. It's really, really good. My kids love this book. I think it's really interesting, and you know, great one to read before you go to the beach as well, because it can give your kids some ideas of the things they're going to find. But yeah, it's just a winner, this book. It's so good. It's well illustrated. It's clear. It's, yeah, it's super fun. And then you can also look through the holes. Another new release this year is The Enormous Morning by Louise Gregg and Lizzie Stewart. Now, I saw this and I knew I wanted it because I had a little peek inside and it looked so beautiful. Look at these illustrations. They're so, so stunning. And I think this, again, is like maybe one of my favourite books from summer. It's about a little girl and her morning and how it grows through the day and more things are added. And the writing, obviously the illustrations are amazing, but the writing in this book is really good too. It's so clever, the way it sort of describes the day expanding and how sort of, you know, things come alive and the light brings things alive. It's just really very poetic and imaginative and quite magical, but making the sort of everyday mundane things magical, which is something I really love. And yeah, just look at this, so beautiful. The illustrations are gorgeous. It's very, very summery. And just yes. So this is Summer's Story by Jill Barklin, the Brambly Hedge series. Of course, I've shown you all this 1,000 times at this point. And if you haven't got the Brambly Hedge collection, you absolutely should. It's so beautiful. The illustrations are so intricate and engaging, and the story is just very charming. If you like things like Beatrix Potter, you will love Brambly Hedge. And also it's a nice longer story for first readers as well. I remember really enjoying these around 10 years old. I thought they were just fantastic. And I'd always love illustrating little mice. So highly recommend the Brambly Hedge series. They will always have a place on my shelves, of course, alongside Shirley Hughes, who I do have in my previous videos, and again, I'll link those below. Okay, so before I wrap up, here are some of our favourite board books, just for those of you with little ones as well. So we've got Summer by Gerda Muller. This one is so well loved. I mean, we've read this so many times. It doesn't have text to it, but you can sort of describe the pictures, which is brilliant for little babies that aren't really reading. We still use this book with my 3-year-old and 5-year-old. I mean, it's such a classic, and I think for young children, it's just such a great series. There's a spring, summer, autumn, and winter. We've got Pippa and Pelle and The Summer Sun by Daniela Drescher. I love these books, as you can see, again, very well loved. The spine is kind of crumbling on this one. They're such cute tales. It always starts off in their cozy little home and they go on a little seasonal adventure, meet some animals, and then they always go home at the end. So it's very comforting, makes a great bedtime story, and I just love these little gnomes. They're just so cute. Going back to the idea of fireflies, this is a great book by Eric Carle. This is a book that we read all the time. My 3-year-old loves this. It's all about a little firefly looking for his friends. I think Eric Carle's illustrations are very engaging. And right at the end, there's a little twinkly page, which is just gorgeous. A new series that I discovered last year is this Eva Marie Ott Heidemann books. And this is the Sommer, so obviously it's like a German book, but so gorgeous. Look at these illustrations. They are a bit, reminds me very much actually of Gerda Muller, but a more sort of whimsical Waldorf style of illustration. And again, no words, but it shows you all the different things you can do outside. This would be fantastic for all ages, especially like young children, toddlers, babies. So gorgeous. This is definitely one that we put on our shelves. I just wanted to show it to you as a board book, along with these other ones. And then this one has also been a real favourite of mine. It's Rain or Shine by Ronald Heinick, I believe it's called. This brings you through the whole year. Again, it's a wordless book, which I love. And then for the summer one, this is a well-loved page of my children's. And then it kind of goes into apple season, autumn, and then winter. So charming, so simple. And you can purchase this from Florist Books. And if you purchase this directly off Florist Books, you can actually choose a free book. So each month they change up the books. And at the moment they have a book called Connected Kids, I think, or no, it's actually called Mindful Kids, and it's really good. It's all about how to teach children meditation and calmness, so I highly recommend that because I'm actually reading that at the moment. So I do recommend that, and I think that's everything. I've got tons more summer books that I could show you, but I'm going to call it a day. If you want to go find me on Instagram, I'm at Slow Natural Mama. That's where I share all my beautiful books and morning baskets and things like that. And I'm also, my main account is at Becky O'Cole, where I garden, I'm a herbalist, and I'm a farmer. So you can check out all those things. I'll link them below. And again, if you enjoyed this video, do consider popping over to Patreon and becoming a patron. You can support this channel each month, and in return, I give you loads of free content. So do consider that, because it makes such a difference. And yes, that's it. I'm going to go now and go play with my kids and read them some stories. I hope this has given you loads of ideas for beautiful books to keep you going over the coming weeks. If you have any favourites, do leave them in the comments below, because I love learning more books from you guys as well. And yeah, have a beautiful summer, and I will be back soon with another video. Bye!